St. Mary's School, Class of 2024, would like to welcome you here tonight for our graduation ceremony. We have come here tonight to thank God for our families, friends, and for all many blessings over the past 9 years. We have made friends and learned many lessons about life from our teachers and from each other. We have also gathered to pray for our future success and happiness. This is a time of great joy as we move on to high school and the many challenges that await us there. We will be sad to leave our SMS family, but we look forward to a bright future. The opening song is Gather Your People.
Would you please join in singing our opening hymn, Gather Your People?
Gather your people, O Lord.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
And good evening.
Good evening, Father.
And welcome to this exciting night as we graduate these 7 eighth graders from junior high school at St. Mary's School. I want to thank the parents for doing such a wonderful job cleaning them up tonight. I know sometimes it takes scrub brushes and garden hoses, but they look really good. Right. Well, anyway, we gather here tonight on this wonderful evening and beautiful evening that God has given us to celebrate these young people, to celebrate that the love that they had for their school, the love they have for their families. And as they move forward to high school, we send them with our blessing. But before we do that, let us just take a moment to call to mind our sins.
Lord Jesus, you scatter the darkness of sin and death. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you announce the good news of salvation to all. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring justice and mercy to the world. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life. Amen. And everyone, please be seated except for the graduates.
Include us.
And at our baptism, we receive the light of Christ. Our parents promised to keep it burning brightly. Now we will light the candle, and our graduates will light their candles. In doing this, we remember our baptism and the share it gives us in the life of Christ, who is our life. As we nurture our life in Christ and use our gifts and service to others, we too become light for the world. Everyone, please stand and let us pray. God, our Father, we thank you for calling us in Christ to be salt for the earth and light to the world. Grant this time of prayer and reflection might strengthen our desire to shine brightly in Christ's name and to use the gifts you have given us to serve others in love. We make this prayer to you through Christ our Lord. Amen. You may now be seated for the reading of Scripture.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Philippians. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing the things that you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, and the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The day the Lord has made, let us rejoice and be glad.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Philippians. Every time I pray for you, all of you, I pray with joy, remembering how you have helped spread the good news from the day you first heard it right up to the present. I'm quite certain that the one who began this good work in you will see that it is finished when the day of Christ Jesus comes. My prayer is that your love for each other may increase more and more and never stop improving your knowledge and deepening your perception so that you can always recognize what is best, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand. Is listening. Speak your words of wisdom, for the words you speak are everlasting life. Alleluia, alleluia,
be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
With a loud crowd gathering, as people from every town find their way to him, he used this parable. A sower went out to sow his seed. As he sowed, some seeds fell on the edge of the path and were trampled on, and the birds of the air ate it. Some seeds fell on rock, and when it came up, it withered away, having no moisture. Some seed fell amongst thorns, and the thorns grew with it and choked it. And some seed fell into rich soil, and it grew and produced its crop 100-fold. Saying this, he cried, "Listen, anyone who has ears to hear." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. And again, good evening. So on behalf of myself and Father Benny and Deacon Dan and our parish, our school, the faculty, parents, all of us, grandma and grandpas, we want to congratulate you tonight as you move on from this big step in your lives. It may not seem that of a big step right now because I think a lot of you are thinking about, you know what, tomorrow morning I could sleep in. Which is good, right? We deserve some rest after such a tough time. But before you go to bed tonight, I'm asking you just to think about the gospel we just heard. What grain of wheat are you? Are you the grain of wheat that falls on rocky ground? Are you the grain of wheat that is sown in such a place that the birds pick it up and carry it away? Or are you the grain of wheat that finds good soil, that's nourished with water, that grows and prospers? That's who you are. That's who you are. And never forget that. Through these years that you've been with us at St. Mary's, these years that your parents have been saying, take out the garbage, make your bed, do this, do that, do this. No, I want to play on my phone. Sound familiar? After all of that, you've made it to this point. And you should be happy and excited as I and all of us here are happy and excited. I promised them the other day as we went out for dinner, the adequate dinner, that I wouldn't embarrass them tonight by asking them questions. So you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to ask your parents questions. Does that sound like a plan? Miss Misty the other night took us all, or yesterday for lunch, took us over to Jerry's, and we had the adequate dinner. And she worked so hard with the 19 years that she's done this to teach these young people how to act in public. Things we need to do. So I'm going to ask the parents. Some of you are graduates of here, so you might, if it's 19 years, you probably went through it. You're at dinner, and a young lady needs to use the restroom. What do the men do? Ooh, pull the chair out and stand. Someone listened. When you receive your napkin, gentlemen, because Father did this, do you get your napkin and tuck it in and go, I'm ready to eat? Or do you place it on your lap? What? You said you don't even use a napkin? No, you know, these are really, it was fun, wasn't it? We had a lot of fun. We had a lot of fun this whole week. We was over at the house, and we had pizza, and we celebrated here at the school, and we did our field trips. It's a lot of fun, but it's all part of growing up, making memories, and living. Yesterday, I got called to our hospital, and I was called there to perform a sacrament. And you all know that sacrament is called the sacrament of the sick, the sacrament of healing. And I walked into the room, and there laying in the bed was a 75 20-year-old Vietnam war vet. And he looked up at me and he said, "Father, I'm scared. I'm scared. I'm having a procedure tomorrow morning, and I'm really scared." Well, Father, in trying to uplift like I do, I said to him, I said, "Don't worry. You are at one of the best hospitals in the area. You have some of the best cardiologists that will work with you. And I want to tell you something else. Jesus is here with you, walking with you." He said, "Father, that all sounds good and it helps me, but I'm still frightened." And I said, there's no reason not to be. Anytime we experience something that unusual, we have that fear in our hearts. We have that fear. But he said, "Father, here's another thing. I want to share it with you." And I said, "Please do." He asked me, he said, "Could I be buried if something happens on May the 2nd? Well, I said, "Well, first of all, nothing's going to happen, okay? But yes, you could be buried on May the 2nd. So Father started thinking. He got very curious about May the 2nd. And I said, "Would you mind sharing with me about May the 2nd? What's so important about May the 2nd? I remember this is going to be a year. By the way, I talked to him this morning. He's doing fine, so don't look so gloom. He went through it flying colors, okay? What's so important about May the 2nd? He said, "Father, I want to tell you. May the 2nd, 1969, me and 100 of my platoon members, many of them were friends, were on Hamburger Hill in Vietnam. And at that evening, five of us remained. Five of us. Father, I am the last of the remaining five." Pretty tough, isn't it? The reason I share this with you tonight is because the memories that happen in our lives, the things that happen in our lives, stay with us. They go with us. This gentleman remembered this just like it was yesterday, something so traumatic in his life. And he shared it with me, and I asked him if I could share it with you tonight, and he said yes. That's something that you will have to face throughout your lives. Things will be wonderful. You know, you're going to go to college, some of you. Some of you go to work. Going to get an education. You're going to find that boyfriend or girlfriend. Get married. Have them kids, grandkids. And then you're going to retire. What memories will you have from that time in your life when you do retire? Now, I know all you looking at me like, "Retire? I ain't even got a grade school yet." But I want you to remember that. How wonderful was that when he shared that with me, shared such an important moment in his life. And a lot of us here know that many of our Vietnam veterans that fought came back and they didn't receive the best welcome back home. Not the best at all. And we forget that there's always hurt and there's pain, but there's rejoicing too. Just think when they came back and the wives and family were sitting there waiting for them and hugged them and kissed them and loved them. Those things happen also. Prepare your life. Be that grain of wheat that falls to good ground, that is embedded into that soil. Allow that grain of wheat that is you to grow strong throughout your lives so that when you are 75, you can remember all the good that you've had in your life and reflect and share that wisdom that you have seen as you lived. I bet I can ask anyone here where they were on a certain date in a life. If I said, where was you on September the 11th, 2001, I bet everybody could raise their hands. Where were you on that fateful day in November 1963? Well, some of you. When President Kennedy was assassinated. I even remember where I was when, I think 1981, when Saint Pope John Paul II had an assassination attempt on him. I was in the college parking lot starting my car and the radio came on and I heard it. Those are the memories that you're going to remember. Those weren't the best ones, I said, but you're also going to remember the fun ones, the great ones that you had here together with you. In concluding, you are the grain of wheat. You are God's chosen. You have the world in front of you. You have that opportunity to make those memories, to make those beautiful memories. Do it. Be something in your lives. Really be something. But never forget that so many people were behind you that allowed you to become who you will become someday. Again, congratulations, graduates. I am so proud of you. I'm going to miss you dearly. It's a really tough time for faculty and staff and priests. Of course, parents and grandparents too. But always remember, we're with you. And never forget, you have a home at St. Mary's. And let us stand now as we bring our prayers and our petitions to God.
For the Holy Catholic Church, for Pope Francis, Bishop McGovern, Father Steve, Father Benny, and all the bishops, priests, and deacons, that they continue to guide us in the ways of faith, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our school community, for the administrators, teachers, and staff, that they continue to form the minds and hearts of all the students, allowing them to grow in faith and intellect, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our graduates, that they strive to excel in everything that they do, and that they carry the love of Christ with them always, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving, for those who have helped our graduates achieve excellence, for parents, grandparents, family members, and friends, we pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, especially Dr. Charles Fisher and Donald and Beverly Kelly, and all the departed alumni of our school, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And I now ask that our graduates pick up their programs and turn to the Youth Creed. And along with Father Benny, myself, and Deacon Dan, we say, we believe in the greatness of our vocation to be salt and light for God's kingdom. We believe that God has called us into this world for a purpose which we can discover only in prayer and in loving service to others. We believe in the gift of parents and giving thanks to all who have done through happy and difficult times to bring us to this day. We believe our teachers, educational assistants, principal, and support staff have been given the wisdom, knowledge, and patience to guide us through our school years for graduation. We believe that we are a sacramental people called to the fullness of light through baptism, to be strengthened, nourished, and renewed through communion,
confirmation,
and the sacraments. We believe in the gift of being a community of faith led by our pastor, parents, and educators. We believe in the gift of joy, living through play, laughter, and sharing in our schools. We believe in practicing social justice as witnesses to God's kingdom preached by Jesus our Lord. And finally, we believe in God the Father, in Jesus Christ, his Son, and in the Holy Spirit. We believe that God loves us and will continue to bless us as we move on to the next stage of our education. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. My friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and the good of all his holy church. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that as promised by your Son, the Holy Spirit may reveal to us more abundantly the hidden mystery of sacrifice and graciously lead us into truth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as a Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You may be seated or you may kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate this mystery. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which shall be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to a second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with the Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, his spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world, be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the lay people you have gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you, In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy
that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. glad you're feeling better.
As we proclaim your death, as we recall your life, we remember your promise.
Hey, mister.
To return again.
Oh, I'm blessing you.
Christ, our brother, feed us now, give us life, lead us to one another. The bread we break and share was scattered once as grain, just as now it is gathered.
So many choices are you?
Bread of life, hope of the world, Jesus Christ, our brother, feed us now, give us life, lead us to one another. We eat this living we drink this saving cup, sign of hope in our broken world, source of lasting love, bread of life, hope of the world, Jesus Christ, our brother, feed us now. Thus in unity, in love for all to see, that the world may believe in you. God of all who live, bread of life, hope of the world, Jesus Christ, our brother.
Let us pray. Bring those you refresh with this heavenly sacrament, most merciful Father, to imitate constantly the example of the Holy Family of your one begotten Son, so that after the trials of this world, they may share their company forever through Christ our Lord. I ask you now to all, please be seated. All of us, I'm going to go down.
Good evening. As educators, we are constantly reflecting on our own personal practices. We look to improve ourselves and the experiences we provide. Today, seeing some of these graduates leave at 12:30, it showed me that in some way we provided them with something that they loved. Although excited about graduating, there was a sense of sadness. Whether it was that they would miss the closeness of a small parochial school, miss their friends, miss their teachers, or miss the safety that they felt when here, I won't know, but there was something there that made them pause and feel some of those emotions. I am thankful that whatever experience it was that they had over the last year or the last 10 years, it led them to that feeling. You seven graduates are extraordinary in your own ways. None of you are alike, yet you all bring your personal touches into the world. We have done as much as we can to prepare you for your next steps. We hope that you take what we have tried to provide you with and apply it in your next endeavors. You have been taught respect, discipline, even when you didn't want it, all of the academics, and most importantly, faith in how you are supposed to treat people. What you do with it is up to you. I leave you with this advice based on something a college basketball coach recently told my son. He said, "Show me your friends and I'll predict your future." Jackson, Addie, Kirsten, Reese, Caden, Julie, and Manil, the future is yours for the taking. Something I read recently said, if you hang around 5 successful people, you will be the 6th one. If you hang around 5 kind, rule-following people, you will be the 6th one. If you hang around 5 positive people, you will be the 6th one. If you hang around 5 unmotivated people, you will be the 6th one. Follow the rules. You will have them for the rest of your lives. In the moment that you don't follow the rules, and it's going to happen, accept your consequence and learn from it. That's how we become better humans. Behave and treat people the way that you want to live your life and the legacy that you want to leave. Earn the respect of the adults around you and choose the friends that will predict the brightest future. Go out and be great and know that we will be cheering you on. We're going to present our special awards first, and then we'll do the diplomas. First is the valedictorian award, and this goes to the student who has the overall highest GPA. It was a close race this year, as we have a lot of excellent students, but today's valedictorian award goes to Reese Kester.
Good evening, and thank you everyone for attending our graduation. I'm extremely honored to be speaking on behalf of the graduating class of 2024. Change can be a scary topic. Not knowing what will happen next can be difficult. Matthew 6:34 says, "Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own." There are going to be times in your life that are going to be extremely hard, but you can't spend all your time worrying about what will happen next. For example, right now might be hard for many people here. Some may be sad, and others may be scared, but we should all enjoy this moment. It is important to spend your time enjoying the little things in life. Taylor Swift once said, "Decide what is yours to hold and let the rest go." In your life, you have to decide what to hold on to and what to let go of. If you hold on to too much bad stuff, you won't have any room for the best parts of your life. Drama is a joy sucker, so avoid it. Respect and trust are not rights. You have to earn them. Don't be afraid to make mistakes, because they help you to grow and learn. These are just a few out of the many things I have learned throughout my years at St. Mary. These lessons have brought me to where I am today and will continue to guide me throughout the rest of my life. I've had so much fun here at St. Mary, and this year was no exception. I want to say thank you to my class for making this one of the best years I've ever had at St. Mary. I would also like to say thank you to a few specific people that have always helped me when I needed it. To all the teachers at St. Mary, thank you for always pushing me to be the best I can be. Miss Maria, I couldn't think of a better principal than you. You are always willing to help, and you make everything fun. You have given me so much great advice throughout the years, and I'm so glad to have had you as a teacher and principal. Ms. Klosterman, thank you for making my last 2 years at St. Mary's the best I have ever had, and thank you for all the great advice you have given me. Mom and Dad, thank you for everything that you do for our family. I love you both so much. Annika, I know we don't always get along, but I love you. I'm going to miss you a lot next year. Addie, I'm so glad we're graduating together. Thank you for always being my best friend and for always making me feel better when I'm upset. I can't wait to go to high school with you. And thank you to my whole family for always supporting me in all that I do. I wish the best of luck to the graduating class in high school and all that you do in your life. I hope you all enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you.
I'm missing my write-up for the other awards, so I'm going to ad-lib a little bit. Be gentle with me. The next award we have goes to the exemplary graduate. There isn't any real criteria for this award. However, it generally goes to the student who we feel displays what we're trying to teach here. Kindness, tolerance of others, hard work in education, and that child who's going to go off and people are going to say that child came from St. Mary's School. This year's exemplary graduate goes to Manil Sharesta. The Larry Williams Memorial Literacy Award is given to the student who displays a love of reading or who works really hard at their AR points, basically. Larry Williams was the husband of Mrs. Patty Williams, and he passed away some years ago, and he was an avid reader, and he was very fond of helping children grow. This year's winner has read over 4 million words based on her reading, and it has helped her along the way, and she's worked really hard for that. This year's winner is Julie Siegler. The next award is the Citizenship Award. This is for a person who is a positive role model to others, demonstrates responsibility, politeness, and who is always caring and respectful with those she interacts with at St. Mary Parish, with children, with adults, and it's my pleasure to announce Addison Hawes as the Citizenship Award winner. Oh.
Congratulations.
The last award is the Robert Reagan Harris Memorial Award. Robert Reagan Harris was a graduate of St. Mary's School, and he suffered from hemophilia. And he was the kind of person who went above and beyond to help everyone and anyone. And his classmates have honored him for a very long time for that. So the recipient of this award is someone who serves at Mass, always willing to serve at Mass. She's willing to do anything that's asked of her, and she's willing to offer to help anyone. She doesn't even have to be told. And this year's winner is Julie Siegler.
Thank you. I would invite all of the members of the faculty and the staff, if they'd like to come forward and just line up right here as we give out the diplomas.
And now for the presentation of the class of 2024, Addison Elizabeth Hawes. Jackson Morris Hodge.
Excellent. Congratulations. There you go. Go shake your teacher's hands. Come back. There you go. Now go to the mescal instrument. Okay.
Congratulations.
Jackson.
They didn't practice that earlier. Reese Olivia Kester.
Turn around.
Congratulations.
Here we go. Okay. Go to Mrs. Classroom. There you go.
Kirsten Malie Page Pender.
Congratulations.
Caden Michael Ramey.
Congratulations.
Manil Shrestha.
Congratulations.
Julie Ray Siegler.
Congratulations. Thank you.
Those are our graduates for this year. Congratulations.
So we'll do another thing you probably didn't practice. I now invite our new graduates to stand and to come forward and to stand on the steps here. And I invite everyone to please stand. You may turn around and face us. Very good. Okay. So we are so happy that you've reached this point, and we want to send you forth with a blessing. So I'm going to ask all of us here present to raise their hands in prayer as we pray for you and bless you as you move forward. God, our Father, we give you thanks for bringing these young people to this special moment in their lives. We ask you to accompany them as they face new adventures and challenges. May the paths they take always lead to you and to the eternal joy that is their inheritance through baptism. We make this prayer to you in the name of Jesus, your Son. Amen. And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Amen. The Mass has ended. Go in peace, using the gifts the Lord has given you to serve each other.
Thanks be to God. And now, students, we say, love of God, love each other, transform our world. Love of God, love each other, transform our world. Amen. I now present to you the St. Mary's School graduating class of 2024.
Your own, your holy people, light for those.